Hashtag wanderlust. Hashtag, okay, I will stop at this point before a visibly annoyed Remedian escorts me out for bad sentence formation. You all must be wondering why I am sprouting out hashtags after hashtag, correct? Okay, let us do this one, this thing. Clap your hand once if you use Instagram at least once a day. Clap your hand twice if your feed is filled with travel photos by your friends. Well, the same thing happened to me. I have been using Instagram and I see that my feed is filled with these amazing photographs of breathtaking places that my friends have been posting, and I am in awe. I'm not a traveler. I never wanted to be one. I always thought that traveling is for two kinds of people. One who have money, another one who has limitless energy. I was proved wrong on both these accounts. The former happened when one of my friends was going to Himachal Pradesh on a sabbatical. I know for a fact that he doesn't have enough funds for the trip, and I asked him what he was doing for the money. And he told me that he will be taking up odd jobs for the money part. And those odd jobs were teaching at a school, driving a tractor, and even farming. Another very impactful anecdote was told to me by a friend. I met him in a travel group, and he told me that for his funding to Alaska, he joined a science experiment group, which was going to study about the northern lights of Alaska. That's how he funded his travel. Now, I realized from these two people that it's not always about the money. It's about their passion and willpower. As for the latter one, which is a limitless energy, I myself proved it wrong. This happened when I went to Udupi. A little background story. I'm an extremely lazy person. I love sleeping more than I love anything in this world. So for someone like me to go to Udupi on a weekend, that was Sunday morning, wake up and go surf, was not very exciting news. I was not very enthusiastic about it, but then I went ahead anyway. And then I think this was one of the most amazing, fun experience of my life, because I started loving water, and also something else happened. I thought this is the experience I don't mind waking up for. I had an instructor who told me at the end of surfing that what he does is he just sits on the surfing board and sees the sunset. And I thought, why not? Let me try. And that's what I did. I sat on the surfing board for about 15 minutes and just looked at the sunset. I guess that was my moment of peace. It looked brilliant and it looked wonderful. I'm not a traveler, but I guess at that point I wanted to be one desperately. Now, apart from being lazy, I'm also a compulsive lister. I make lists whenever I decide to do something. In fact, my lists have lists. So, I tried to note down all kind of advices that I have gotten from various people about traveling. So, the three most important things that an established traveler have told me and from various blogs that I have read from is that, one, you need to be open to an idea of new experiences. Be prepared to be welcomed by people. Be prepared to be being treated badly by people. Be prepared to being ill at your trip. The second one was that follow your gut. Listen to your gut. If your gut says that, hey, this doesn't seem right, if your hotel seems just out of a horror movie, then don't stay there. Especially for females, if you're going in an auto and then you feel that the driver is taking a wrong route, tell him, be assertive, listen to your gut, because sometimes it's right. And my favorite tip that most travelers have told me was, travel to make stories. Ibn Battuta once said that traveling leaves you speechless, and then it turns you into a storyteller. Don't sit in your hotel and order room service. Go out, meet the locals, play with the kids, dance in the rain, wear that crazy hat which looks ridiculous. It's okay. Try to make as many stories as possible. All in all, from whatever little experience I have from traveling, I have come to a conclusion that traveling is similar to being in love. At first, when you go to a city, you feel nervous. Your heart skips a beat whenever you see a breathtaking scenery. Then you experience a surreal feeling. At some times your heart will break because someone catcalled you or the locals mistreated you. But then when you just thought that this was not the city for you, the city lures you back in by feeding you delicious food and the warm welcome by the other locals. At one point in your journey, you'll arrive at a place where you'll feel like home away from home. This is the place you'll leave your soul in before you go on to your next adventure. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not a traveler, but I desperately want to be one to experience this feeling a million times over. Back to the Toastmasters.